chain breaking today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Praise God. Praise God. Those chains that bind, he'll break them off of you.
Yeah.
Praise God. Good to see each one in the house of God, to worship him this morning. God bless us. Another day and another opportunity to be in his house. Take advantage of being in the house of God today.
That's right.
Yes.
Take advantage of worshiping God today. You took the time to get up this morning and get ready and get out to the house of God. Take advantage of it.
That's right. Amen.
Amen. Worship God in this place today. Praise God. Book of 1 Samuel, the 16th chapter. We'll start reading at the 10th verse. 1 Samuel 16 and 10. Again, Jesse made seven of his sons to pass before Samuel. And Samuel said unto Jesse, the Lord hath not chosen these. And Samuel said unto Jesse, are here all thy children? And he said, there remaineth yet the youngest, and behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, send and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he come hither. And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance and goodly to look to. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Praise God. Let's praise him one more time. God, we love you. God, we praise you for your Spirit that we feel in this place today, God. Lord, we ask God that you just come down and anoint, God, this word today. Anoint your speaker. God, anoint the hearts and ears of those, God, out listening in the audience, God, that your will can be accomplished. Let it all be done for thy glory, Lord. We'll praise you in Jesus' name. Praise God. You can be seated. Of course, many of you know the story of David, how that he was anointed to be king over Israel. But the Bible said that when Samuel took the horn of the oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren, that the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. Now, it wasn't the oil that anointed David, it was the Spirit that came upon him. Many of you know the story of David, how that the Philistines were in battle with the children of Israel, and of course, Goliath came on the scene, and of course, David challenged that fight. There was a reason that David challenged that fight. First of all, that he was anointed of God. So for a little while this morning, I want to preach to you a warrior anointing. David was a warrior. How many know David was a warrior?
Yes, sir.
You know the story. If you read the story of David, there were times when David would come into a place and they would begin to sing and shout. You know, Saul has slain his thousands, but David his 10,000. So David was a man of war. That was one reason he had a desire to build the temple of God, but he couldn't build the temple of God because he was a man of war.
Yes, he was.
But David had a warrior anointing about him. We begin to read on in the story of David and Goliath going to Goliath had challenged the children of Israel. Now David had come to the camp to check on his brothers. And Bible said in verse 32, David found out what was going on, and he wanted to know, who this Goliath was and who this uncircumcised Philistine was. And finally, Bible said that chapter 17, verse 32, and David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Thy servant will go and fight with this Philistine. Now, if you read back, even before that, David was Saul's armor bearer. Mm-hmm. If you go on back and read even before that. But David had a warrior's heart. or he had a warrior's anointing about him. And he said, don't you let no man's heart fail because of him. I'll go and fight him. And Saul said to David, you're not able to go up against this Philistine to fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and he a man of war from his youth. But what John didn't know was David had a warrior anointing. The Spirit of God would come up on him. Bible said from the time that Samuel anointed him, Bible said that the Spirit of the Lord would come up on David from that day forward. So notice what he said. He said, and David said unto Saul, thy servant kept his father's sheep. And there came a lion and a bear and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he rose up against me, I caught him by his beard and smote him and slew him. There was no way David as an ordinary man could have done that on his own. It was because he had been anointed by God, and the Spirit of God would come upon him in those times that the Spirit of God needed to be there in his life.
Amen.
For he said, thy servant slew both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing he had defied the armies of the living God. And David said, moreover, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion, out of the paw of the bear, he would deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said unto David, go, and the Lord be with thee. Of course, if you drop down to verse 45, the Bible says that, then said David to the Philistine, thou comest to me with a sword, and with a spear, and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. So David knew where his anointing came from.
Amen.
David knew where his strength came from.
Amen.
He knew where his power came from. And he knew that he had a warrior anointing about him. In other words, he knew that he was going to fight.
Right.
He knew when the enemy came against him, he was going to fight.
Yeah.
Now, I want you to notice something. That the Spirit of the Lord would come upon David. That was the reason David was able to slay the lion. That was the reason David was able to slay the bear. That was the reason he was able to catch him by the beard. You don't go up and catch a lion by the beard. Not one. You don't do that unless you're anointed of God.
Amen.
And the power of God come upon you. And a bear too, he slew the bear in the same manner. You know, we often think of maybe he slew it with a sling. No, he slew those with his bare hand.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But it was because he had a warrior anointing about him. That was the reason he was able to kill Goliath. He said, I come to you in the name of the Lord. It wasn't the strength of David.
Right.
It was that warrior anointing that he had about him. That's the reason he was able to win in the battles that he fought. And that's the reason that David's men were so faithful and followed him so was because of that warrior anointing about him. But not only that, if you begin to look, David in Psalms 22, he realized where his strength came from, or in 2 Samuel 22. In verse 29, 2 Samuel 22, David realized where his strength came from and where his power came from. He began to write in 2 Samuel 22 and 29. He said, for thou art my lamp, O Lord, and the Lord will lighten my darkness. For by thee have I run through a troop. By my God have I leaped over a wall. As for God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is tried. He is a buckler to all them that trust in him. For who is God save the Lord? And who is a rock save our God? Now look at verse 33. God is my strength and power. God is my strength and power. and he maketh my way perfect. He maketh my feet like hinds' feet, and setteth me upon my high places. Look at verse 35. He teacheth my hands to war. He said, God taught me this.
Amen.
God taught me how to use my warrior anointing. God taught me how to do this.
Amen.
He teaches my hands to war so that a bow of steel is broken by mine arms. Thou hast also given me the shield of thy salvation, and thy gentleness has made me great. Thou hast enlarged my steps unto me, so that my feet did not slip. I have pursued my enemies and destroyed them, and turned not again until I have consumed them. Mm-hmm. Talking about the enemy. I mean, no, we got an enemy.
Amen.
But David had a warrior anointing. Mm-hmm. Had a warrior anointing. But not only David, some of those in David's army had a warrior anointing about them. Because some of the feats that they did, they couldn't do it unless the Lord was with them.
Right.
I want you to notice. In Psalms, y'all hang with me because I'm going to get to my point here in a little bit. Bless the Lord.
Amen.
In 2 Samuel 23, in verse 8, these be the names of the mighty men whom David had. The Tachamite that sat in the seat, chief among the captains. The same was Adono. The east knight, he lifted up his spear against 800 whom he slew at one time. Couldn't do that unless you had a warrior anointing about him. And after him was Eleazar, the son of Dodo, the a Kohite, one of the three mighty men with David, when they defied the Philistines that were gathered together to battle, and the men of Israel were gone away. And he arose and smote the Philistines until his hand was weary and his hand clave unto the sword. But notice, it didn't say he won the victory. And the Lord wrought a great victory that day.
Right.
It was from the power of God. It was from the anointing of God. It was because they had a warrior anointing about them. And wrought a great victory, and then people returned after him only to spoil. And after him was Shammah, the son of Abi, and the Hararite. And the Philistines were gathered together into a troop, where was a piece of ground full of lentils. And the people fled from the Philistines. But he stood in the midst, talking about Shammah. He stood in the midst of the ground and defended it and slew the Philistines. And the Lord wrought a great victory. The Lord wrought it. Why?
Amen.
Because you don't do that just being an ordinary man.
Right, right.
You do it when you have a warrior anointing about you. You do it when the Spirit of God comes upon you.
Yes, come on.
Praise God. Praise God. We need, he said he stood in the middle. And no telling how many times the Philistines had come into where the Israelites was, and it destroyed their crops. That ground, that piece of ground, it was a pea patch. The Bible said he stood in the middle of it and defended his ground. You know, there's not a one of us in here. There's not a one of us in here that if somebody was breaking into our house in trying to harm our family, that we wouldn't fight back.
Right.
We would defend it with every ounce of strength and every ounce of breath in us.
Amen.
Yet we sit passive and let the devil steal everything we've got.
Right.
Oh, if it was in the natural, well, if it was in the natural, if they done that, well, I'd really be on them. I'd really be getting them. I'd really be after them. They better not try to come in on me. They better not try to come in on my family. I'd stand up and fight. Yet we sit there passive while the devil steals things from us. Bible said he's come, that Satan has come to steal, kill, and destroy. And we sit there passive and let him do it. Now somebody in you ought to get a warrior's anointing about it.
Amen.
Look at the book of Judges. We marvel at the strength of Samson.
Mm-hmm.
We marvel about the story of Samson killing the lion with his bare hands. Well, David did the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
why? Because it was by the same anointing, by the same spirit. It's where they got their strength from. Look at Judges 13:7. The children of Israel did evil again in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord delivered them into the hand of the Philistines 40 years. There was a certain man of Zorah of the family of the Danites, whose name was Manoah, and his wife was barren and bare not. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto the woman and said unto her, Behold now, thou art barren, and bearest not, but thou shalt conceive and bear a son. Now therefore, beware, I pray thee, and drink not wine or strong drink, and eat not any unclean thing. For lo, thou shalt conceive and bear a son, and no razor shall come upon his head, for the child shall be a Nazarite unto God from the womb, and he shall begin to deliver Israel out of the hand of the Philistines. And then dropping down to verse 24, and the woman bare a son, and called his name Samson. And the child grew, and the Lord blessed him. And this is what And the Spirit of the Lord began to move him at times in the camp of Dan between Zorah and Eshtaol. The Spirit of the Lord began to move him.
Amen.
Spirit of the Lord, he had a war. Samson had a warrior anointing, right? Samson had a warrior anointing. If you read the story where he basically tore a lion in half. Bible said the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him. The enemy would rise up against Samson. The Philistines would rise up against Samson. The Samson would shake himself, and that warrior anointing would come upon him, and he was able to do great things. Because the Spirit of God would come upon him.
Amen.
He had a warrior's anointing. He had a warrior's anointing. Now, let's go all the way to Acts 1:8. But ye shall receive power.
Amen.
After that the Holy Ghost is come upon you.
Amen.
And you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. The Bible said from the time David was anointed, from that day forward, the Spirit of the Lord would come upon him. The Bible said that the Spirit of the Lord would come upon Samson. They had a warrior's anointing. The Bible tells us that we shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon us. A warrior's anointing. A warrior's anointing. So many times we let the enemy, we sit there passive when the enemy comes in and steals everything we've got. Could I tell you, one of the worst things we could do is let the enemy steal us blind. You've heard the phrase, man, they'll steal you blind. One of the worst things, we let him take everything else from us. And the next thing you know, he stole us blind. What do you mean he stole us blind? He's got us to the place that we can't see where we're at.
Right.
There's no anointing anymore.
Amen.
See, Samson messed around until he failed God. They cut off the locks of his head. They said, the enemy be upon you. And he rose up to shake himself. The Bible said that he wist not or he knew not that the Spirit of God had departed from him. What had happened? Satan had robbed him blind.
Amen.
Satan had got to the place he didn't realize where he was anymore. So we can sit around passive when the enemy comes against us, or we can get up and shake ourselves and let the Spirit of God come upon us and let that warrior anointing come upon us, and we can defend our ground.
All right.
We can defend our ground. See, I think sometimes we get the wrong idea of a child of God. Sure, we're supposed to have a meek spirit about us. But a meek don't mean weak.
That's right.
Meek means controlled power.
Right.
Look at 2 Timothy. The second chapter. First verse, thou therefore, my son, be strong. David was strong, Samson was strong, but it wasn't because of their own power. Be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also. But look at verse 3. Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. So we are in an army.
Amen.
We're in God's army. So we are soldiers. What does a soldier do? They fight when the enemy comes against them.
Right.
Huh? They fight when the enemy comes against them. Then he said, no man that warreth entangle himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier.
Amen.
All right, now, if I'm in God's army, and I have the Holy Ghost in my life, then I have power in my life. I've got a warrior's anointing in my life. And I'm in God's army, and I'm one of his soldiers. So that means when the enemy comes against me, then I should rise up and shake myself with this warrior anointing and do battle with the enemy. First Timothy 6 and 12 says, fight the good fight of faith.
Yes.
Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. Whereunto thou art also called, and hast professed the good profession before many witnesses. Fight. Word of God tells us, fight.
Yes.
Fight the good fight of faith.
Amen.
Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. Psalms 92 and 10. But my horn shall thy exalt like the horn of a unicorn, and I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Sometimes all we need in our lives is just a fresh anointing.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Sometimes all we need to do is cry out, God, return that warrior anointing to me.
Yes, amen.
Return that warrior anointing to me. I'm tired of Satan stealing everything of God. Return that warrior. Anoint me with fresh oil. Anoint me with fresh oil. Praise God. Praise God. Psalm 20th chapter, verse 6 says this. Now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heaven with a saving strength of his right hand. Some trust in chariots and some in horses. But we will remember the name of the Lord our God.
Amen.
They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord, and let the King hear us when we call. For now we know that the Lord saveth his anointed. And then Isaiah 10 and 27. This shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder. The burden of what? The burden of the enemy. The burden of the enemy. This shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck. And the yoke, that yoke of burden, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. You know what? My Lord God, anoint us with fresh oil. God, anoint us with fresh oil. Anoint us with that anointing that destroys.
Amen.
Anoint us with that anointing that destroys the yoke, that destroys the enemy. See, we don't need just relief from it for a while. We need it destroyed.
Right.
We need that burden, that yoke in our life. We need it destroyed, not just calm down, not just quiet for a while, but we need it destroyed. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing, or that warrior anointing. Praise God. David had it. David's men had it. Samson had it. Throughout the Word of God, you find that men had that warrior anointing because they were willing to fight for the cause. David asked the question, is there not a cause? Is there not a cause? There is a cause this morning. Satan wants to destroy you. He wants to destroy your witness. He wants to steal from you. He wants to kill you. But the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. A warrior's anointing. A warrior's anointing. Let me read this. Anointing. Translated from the Greek. An unction. A gift. A special endowment of the Holy Ghost. Maybe I'll read that again. The anointing. An unction, a gift, a special endowment of the Holy Ghost. And ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. A warrior's anointing. Let's all stand. He's tired of Satan taking things from you. Yeah. How many want to say, God, I'm coming to you this morning for strength to fight the enemy? I want that warrior anointing in my life. Why don't you come as the Savior?
Praise you, Lord.
Come on.